Hi, I'm Jim Zwack from the Davey Institute, North America's premier tree research laboratory, and today we're talking trees. The advice your professional arborist gives you is always predicated on one very important thing: knowing the type of tree that may need help. We'll give you a few pointers today, but if you're pressed for time, we'll end this video with a few resources to help you unmask the identity of your tree in short order. To help us today, we're joined by Cody Riedel, Davey scientist and supervisor of our diagnostic laboratory.
We only have a short time today, so we're going to focus primarily on identifying a tree by its leaves. The first step is to determine if a tree is a broadleaf or a conifer. Let's start with this question. Does the tree have needles and cones? If so, it's likely a conifer. Most conifers have individual needles attached to the twigs, with a few having needles in groups that are attached to the twigs. For pines, the number of needles per group is frequently characteristic of the species. As with most other groups in nature, there are exceptions. Fun fact, bald cypress and dawn redwood are both conifers, but also deciduous, dropping their feathery needles each fall after turning a bright, rusty orange. If your tree does not have needles and cones, but broadleaves, it is, you guessed it, a broadleaf. For the most part, broadleaf trees can be divided into two groups based on leaf arrangement. The majority have leaves and buds that have an alternate arrangement along the twig. A few have pairs of leaves that are attached opposite of one another. Another helpful identification characteristic is distinguishing between simple leaves, meaning one leaf blade per leaf, and compound leaves with multiple leaflets attached to a central stem known as the petiole attached to the twig. We could go much deeper, but it's important to remember that leaf identification is only one of the many methods you can use to identify a tree. Arborists often use characteristics such as structure, bark, flowers, buds, and climate to determine identification.
Thanks, Cody. Our arborists spend hours in study and practical field training to hone their tree identification skills. Assuming you don't have that kind of time, we've shared a few resources to help you identify your favorite trees. As always, thanks for talking trees.